What is going on, YouTube? Welcome back to another adventure with the Bearded Bobber. Welcome to the garage. We're going to be talking about helmets. Not this one, kind of, but come on, come with me. All right, YouTube. So I recently went on a 3,000 mile trip to Oklahoma and back for the Kay River Campground, Starved American. If you guys saw on my channel, I have that video up as well. It's a fun time. We had a blast. I cannot wait for next year. Adam Sandoval, you rock, man. Can't wait to do it again. Now, what I want to talk about today is this Shoei helmet. Now, I got this one just a little bit before the campground. Maybe a couple weeks. Had a very small break-in period. And then I did 3,000 miles with it. 2 1Ks, in fact. So I just kind of wanted to give you a quick review of that helmet. A lot of people have been asking about this helmet and my Simpson helmet, which is brand new, still not broken in. I love both of these. I didn't get this one to replace this one. I had them to go with each other. We have a full face, we have a modular. Now, this one I love having with the Challenger, white on white. People think you're a cop. It's pretty fun. But I do like on the long trips having a modular helmet. It's been very good to me. This helmet is the first time I've had a quality helmet. And the Neotech 2 has just been a fantastic helmet. And I want to talk to you guys about it. And we're going to go over it right now. All right, guys. So like I was saying, we're going to talk about the Neotech 2 modular helmet from Shoei. Now, this helmet is fantastic. This has happened to be the color they had. Wouldn't have been my first choice, but it worked out. I usually have a black and a white helmet. But real quick, before we get into this one, I want to talk about this one. This is an HJC. It is the CL17 full face helmet. This is a 3X shell, and I believe it's got 5X padding on the inside. Now, I had this helmet for a little while. Not a bad helmet. I got this one on sale, and when the first time I went to even get a motorcycle, I said, let's check out all the helmets. I put money away to make sure I get a good helmet. I want to be safe. I've lost loved ones who, if they were wearing a helmet, would have lived, especially full face. Not to say I ride without it sometimes, but that's different. We're not talking about that right now. What we are talking about is I wanted a good helmet. $400, $500, $600, whatever. I could have worked it in right then and there to my plan. Unfortunately, I had a very big head and the nice ones didn't fit. So I ended up getting the HJC. Not a bad helmet for me. I thought it was good. My first time riding, I had an IS Max 2 modular helmet from HJC and the CL17. I had two of these. Two of the IS Max, I was content with what I had. I always wanted more. I always was out there looking. I ended up losing weight. If you guys have been following me, you may have seen some difference. I've been on a journey. I'm still on a journey, and I got a lot of things to go, which is kind of hard on buying expensive helmets if you're going to keep losing weight. But I got very excited when I was able to fit this helmet. So I wanted you guys to know where I'm coming from when I went to the Shoei. I didn't come from Arai or like any other of these top end. I didn't have a Simpson at the time. I didn't have anything. I didn't have a Bell, nothing. This is what I had. The helmet never felt bad to me. The padding never felt bad. I fell one time on my bike and a drug on my helmet on a CL17 and I had no issues. But it wasn't going very fast. I wouldn't call it a real accident. I'm glad it was on my head. Now, that all being said, this bad boy, the cushion on the inside, the fabric, it is fantastic. I love the way it feels. It's got a very comfortable feeling. It hugs my ears really well. I do have stretch ears, so sometimes that can be an issue, depending on what plugs I'm wearing. And then I can have issues over like a couple hours of riding, but I've had that with every helmet. This one definitely fits better. One thing is the Neotech 2 is designed for a Senna. Now, it's a certain Senna. It has everything cut out for it. I have Cardo, so I had to make that work. I did it. It's not ideal. But this helmet has, you know, the drop-down visor, which I'm a huge fan of, especially for long trips. It came with the built-in visor, like protector, the shield in here, fog shield, which is absolutely fantastic. If you guys have ridden at night, cold weather, anything like that, having your shield fog up is a total pain in the ass. Bagger, not bagger, no matter what. It's got a really nice vent system right here. And on the top, you can really feel that work in the cold air. Anytime you guys get a vented helmet, that's usually when you're going to notice it the most. You know, good exhaust ports back here. Like I said, everything's very comfortable. If you do run a Senna, the exact Senna for this one, it's got a really nice, like, plug-and-play kind of system where everything inserts. I may do one just because I have friends that run Senna, and I could have both. But I do have more friends that run Cardo. So it wasn't a total buzzkill for me because, like I said, I made it work. It's just kind of in a weird back spot right here. I ended up getting the Motorrad first gen moto mount. I have the second one on this tool, but the way this helmet's designed, if you guys moto vlog, I figure that's an issue. If you're watching my channel, you very well may be doing that yourself. So that's one thing I've kind of ran into an issue with here is trying to mount a camera. I've had to really do it the first time upside down. I have another piece that they sent me that I can have it up right here in the front. So that should be ideal as well. But overall, guys, this has been a fantastic helmet. The noise is very minimum. I've had a little bit of a whistle every once in a while. Nothing crazy. It's been a very, very nice helmet to have. Very comfortable. Like I said, did 2 1Ks with it in the same week within just a few days. 3,000 miles, different kinds of weather. I went from like 40 degrees to 95 degrees. I was going through Palm Springs, North New Mexico, Texas, Oklahoma. I hit some rain. Overall, this helmet was fantastic. I absolutely love it. And I can't say anything, you know, bad about it. I have nothing bad about this helmet. This right here, it's got a very nice, like, the click-in system. So you can just kind of like push in, if I can get it on the camera there. So you can get that little, if you can hear it. And it's a really easy way to like undo and do your helmet without having anything to worry about. Very secure. Doesn't have the loops, so if you have a helmet lock, it's not gonna work. But also, if you live in California or a very populated city, you're probably not leaving a helmet of this price on your motorcycle, especially with just a little helmet lock barely holding in your helmet. So it's definitely something I wouldn't do. This is a 2X helmet from Shoei. I'm very, very happy with it. Very comfortable. Like I said, I lost some weight in my other helmet, hadn't gotten very loose. That's about it, guys. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. I'll be looking forward to see them. Let me know if you have one yourself. It feels very lightweight to me, especially compared to the HAC. Makes the HAC feel like a brick. The Simpson's very light too. I love both helmets. Like I said, I will be going over them later once I get some more miles put on the Simpson. I don't want to do a review on that Simpson when I've only had a couple weeks with it and riding to work. Like, that's just not enough. No break-in, no nothing. But the Shoei, you know, I did that long trip to Stubborn American. It was there through the thick of it, the long days, the, you know, 20 hours of riding in one day. Fabric felt good, you know, sweat, stuff like that. It didn't feel like rugged and rough after like a long, hard day like that. So still going to put it through its paces, you know, and go from there for a long, long-term review. But I think when you've had 4,000 miles on one helmet, I think you have a pretty good feel of what the helmet's going to be like. All right, guys, like I said, if you got any questions, let me know down in the comments. Looking forward to it. I'm going to get out of here, and you guys stay safe, stay classy. I got some more product reviews coming for you guys.